the Fur, Fins, and Feathers Elementary School in the Amazon River Basin, the animals of the rainforest were busy in their respective classes learning about history, science, math, and the civics of the rainforest. Hi, my name is Miss Maya the Morpho Butterfly, and I am the principal. Let's go join our class for our history class for a quick lesson.
Hello, kids. My name is Miss Zuma, and I am obviously a sloth. I am your history teacher. Some kids say that I talk slow, but I just want to make sure you hear everything I say.
Yay! Toucan, bet I love history. It's my favorite subject.
You love every subject, you big nerd.
You're such a bully, Bryce. Just because you can run at speeds of 50 miles per hour doesn't mean you can make fun of everyone else.
Don't talk about my best friend that way. Bryce and I can't help it if everybody loves to learn about all the big cats in Amazon.
Oh, children, stop arguing. I'd like to introduce our new student, Knight the Turtle, who came from us from River Basin Academy.
Hi, Knight.
Hey, Knight.
Hello.
But you're a turtle. You don't belong in our neck of the woods. You certainly can't run as fast as me or Joe the Jaguar.
Unfortunately, we were forced out of our home since the two-legged, furless city dwellers were cutting down trees for farmland and our school was destroyed.
That is terrible, Knight, but I'm glad you brought that up. My lesson today is all about deforestation.
Okay. I did a report on deforestation in second grade. Did you know that 20% of the rainforest has already been lost due to deforestation? My grandparents and great-grandparents had to find new trees to live in because their homes were cut down to make furniture for the two-legged, furless city dwellers.
That happened to my ancestors as well. Our family owned half of the canopy before the loggers came and stole our land and homes.
My grandfather died because he ingested some plastic that he thought was a leaf. Humans ain't fair.
I don't have many predators, but those two-legged, furless city dwellers really scare the living cat claws out of me.
I'm normally pretty peaceful, but if I ran into one of those evil two-legged, furless city dwellers, I'd dunk them headfirst into the water.
Okay, class, that's enough for today. Maybe in your civics class, you can think of a more nonviolent way to inform the two-legged, furless city dwellers.
Hello, class. I'm Mr. Specky, and I am a spectacled owl. Welcome to math class. Today, we are going to learn about statistics.
What are statistics?
Statistics are number facts. For example, more than 20% of the world's oxygen is produced in the Amazon rainforest.
Oh, and all the plants and animals in the rainforest need every ounce of that oxygen. It's crazy.
That's right, kids. And why are statistics important?
Because statistics help us learn about how to help the rainforest.
For example, did you know that the Amazon rainforest covers 5.5 million square kilometers of the world?
And can someone figure out how much that is in miles?
By rough estimation, that is 2.1 million square miles.
I was talking to Bryce the Black Panther at recess, and he said that during his third class, they learned that 20% of the rainforest has been lost due to deforestation.
And did you know that the Amazon has an amazing ecosystem? There are 40,000 plant species, 3,000 types of fish, and 430 mammals.
And don't forget the 1,300 bird species and a whopping 2.5 million different insects. Wow.
So how do we help keep the deforestation numbers down?
That's a good question. You will learn all about how to help our environment in civics class today.
All these numbers are giving me a headache.
Kids, welcome to science class. I'm a new teacher this year, and I'm also Miss Maya, the principal's daughter. We are going to learn all kinds of great scientific rainforest facts.
Hey, I know a cool fact about the rainforest. Did you know that although 6% of the world is covered by rainforest, it is home to half of the animals in the world?
That's correct, mister.
Around 70% of the world's castle treatments are provided by the rainforest.
That's right, Andy. And did you know that there are many medicinal plants in the rainforest?
What does medicinal mean?
It means that the plants are used to make medicine to help heal animals and the two-legged furless city dwellers.
Why would we want to help them?
Well, not all the two-legged furless city dwellers are bad. Some of them actually help protect the rainforest.
Yeah, scientists discovered me in the cave walls and made glowworms famous on the internet.
And don't forget about the two-legged, furless, indigenous Amazonians. They're not bad humans, and they want to protect the rainforest because it's their home, too.
They also depend on the Amazon biffle, as well as the 3,000 known species that live in the Amazon biffle.
20% of Earth's fresh water is produced by the Amazon River, so it's important for all species,
including the two-legged, furless city dwellers.
Well, that's all for today, kids. It's almost lunchtime.
Hey, I think I see Bruce the Black Panther first in the lunch line hunting for prey.
Hi, class. Welcome to civics class. My name is Mr. O the Ocelot, and I am excited to start our lesson.
What is civics?
Civics is the study of the rights and duties of citizenship.
Well, why should we study it?
It is important that we study it because it helps us understand how government works and what we can do to help our community.
It also reminds citizens that they have to be a part of the solutions to save the rainforest.
But we already do a lot to save the rainforest. We are not the problem.
The problem is the greedy, furless, two-legged city dwellers.
Well, they're not all bad, but we do need them to help us save our community.
Well, how do we get them to help us?
I know! We can pack up our bags and go to the city and form a protest. That's a great idea, kids. Peaceful protests are a great way to get a message across.
Let's invite the whole school. Can you imagine the looks on their faces when they see a bunch of tropical animals fighting for their community?
I think the most stunning part is when the greedy, furless, two-legged city dwellers see a bunch of tropical animals holding signs and speaking English.
Help me out, 'cause I need something up to calm me down. Help me out. Help me out.